A very good evening, students. Today we'll start a new unit, Introduction to Memory. So in this lecture we'll cover up what are different types of memories that we have, and with an introduction to RAM and its memory location we'll cut it off. So a memory unit is basically a device which is used for storing information and from where we can extract information. So what is the purpose of extracting information? We extract information for the purpose of processing the information. So while we process the information, we take information from the memory, store it in the register, process it and again put it back into the main memory. So this is about memory unit. Now there are various types of memories that we have: random access memory and read only memory. The memory which we can read but we cannot write onto, and the random access memory is the one which we can read also and we can write also. We can change that memory location and extract the memory location, that is RAM. Here we cannot change the memory location, we can always extract the data from memory location, like listening song from a CD. So that is a ROM CD. And RAM, there are two types of RAMs, SRAM and DRAM. SRAM is a static RAM, DRAM is a dynamic RAM. SRAM is made up of latches and DRAM is made up of capacitor, and this capacitor is made up of metal oxide semiconductor. Now DRAM requires regular refreshing of the memory because it contains a capacitor. With the passage of time, your capacitance decays, and because of that we need to refresh the memory again and again so that it recharges to the desired level. So DRAM requires refreshing again and again, but power consumption here is very low. Here power consumption is low and it is slow. Accessing a memory location using DRAM is slow process. SRAM is fast and it is made up using latches. Then types of memories, we also have volatile and non-volatile memories. Volatile memories are those which can be erased if they are operating without a battery. So they always require a battery or power with them to keep the information. Once battery power is gone, information will be lost. And we have non-volatile memories. Non-volatile memories are those like our computer main memory, even though we are not working on it and it is switched off, still we can store the information in it, and next day when we will switch it on, then same information will be made available to us. So that is non-volatile memory. So we can say non-volatile is ROM. ROM is a non-volatile memory and RAM is a volatile memory. So when there is no power, information from the RAM will be lost, and ROM information will always stay whether there is power or there is no power. Now next is programmable logic devices called PLDs. So there are various types of programmable logic devices: random read-only memory, programmable logic array, programmable array logic, and filled programmable gate array, FPGA. Now why do we call it programmable logic device? Logic device is something like AND gate, OR gate. If we change number of inputs to these gates or combination of these gates, will create us an expression or a functionality, right? So any kind of functionality can be created using logic gates, right? Now can we change the connections to create a different functionality? Yes, we can change. So that changing of pins, changing of the connections is known as programming of the logic devices. And there are various programmable logic devices: the ROM, PLA, PUL, FPGA. Okay, so after this a bit of introduction, we have array logic and conventional logic part of introduction. Conventional logic we so far did was, if we have a OR gate, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This OR gate has 5 inputs. Now if same is to be represented using array logic, then this is input line connected to OR gate and there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 input lines. Now which input line data is to go to the output side, it depends which one is fused and which one is fuses blown. So there are basically fuses. So there are basically connections. So wherever there is a connection, that means its input will be calculated according to OR operation and will reach to the output. So this is array logic and this is conventional logic. Now onwards we'll be using array logic. Next is RAM, basic block diagram of RAM, a memory. Now in this case we have, let's talk of number of inputs. Address is number of inputs. Now address is something, if we have a postman and he has a letter in his hand and he want to put that letter to some destination address. So if this is a big memory, then out of this big memory there will be one location which we want to put data into, or from which location we want to take data from. So how will we identify that what is address of that particular location? This is given by the address lines. Now in this case we have standardized it to k address lines. And whether we are performing read operation on the memory or write operation on the memory, if read is active high, then read operation will be going on. If write is active high, write operation will be going on. N data input lines. These are data input lines and these are data output lines. So whenever read operation is going on, data will not be inputted into the memory. Data will be taken from the memory. Whenever write is active high, then N data input line will be putting data onto the memory locations or writing data onto the memory locations. So this is block diagram of RAM. Let us take an example. 1024 words of 8 bit each. That means there are 1024 memory locations and each memory location has a width of 8 bit. So that means 1028 into 8 bit. So how much total information will be available there? 1024 byte, because 8 bit is equal to byte. And 1024 in computer language is called kilo. Is called kilo. And this is kilobyte. So this is kilobyte of information. Let us take another example. Let us say there are 3 address lines. We say that depending upon number of address lines, this location from where we want to extract data, that will be larger or small. Let's take an example that we have 3 address lines. 3 address lines can address how many possible memory locations? That is 2 raised to power 3 is equal to 8 address are possible. 8 memory locations are possible. Now let us understand how this memory looks like basically. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 0 to 7, these are 8 memory locations and each memory location has 16 bit data. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So, and each box contains one bit of information, either 0 or binary 1. So this is the output side from where we are taking data. Output side. And this is the input side. So number of output lines is same as that of number of input lines. And these addresses, like 8 addresses, are obtained using 3 address lines. So these 3 address lines are connected here. Now whether we are carrying out read operation or write operation, it depends upon the read-write pin. So this is complete a block diagram overview of RAM. And RAM, we know that this is of two type, static RAM and dynamic RAM. In the coming lecture, we'll take detail of it. Thank you very much.